A lot of people are worried about 5G. A while back, there were protests in several cities that drew hundreds of people. Then a few months later, there were arson attacks on cell towers in Auckland. But is there something to worry about? How the technology works is the same principle as radio. Data is transmitted wirelessly on the non-visible parts of the light spectrum. Of course, mobile networks use a different part of the spectrum than AM and FM radio. In fact, that's also one of the key differences between 4G and 5G. 5G is using higher frequencies. Now, you may know that this principle is radiation, and that certain types of radiation can damage cells, like overexposure to X-rays, or the microwave radiation that we use to cook food, or the ultraviolet rays that give us sunburn. But with the frequencies and wavelengths used by 5G, very little of the energy in the radio waves goes deeper than the skin. All the research shows that there are no adverse health effects from 5G technologies. In New Zealand, as in most other countries, there are regulations limiting exposure to radio frequencies. The Resource Management Act requires independent exposure measurements if a cell tower is believed to be exceeding one quarter of the public limit. But in reality, the highest exposures at most sites are more than 100 times below the public limit. A lot of the people spreading misinformation are doing so not aware that that's what they're doing. If there was a technology that was going to harm people, speaking out against it would be the right thing to do. But some of those are doing so to serve their own interest. One company was selling a 5G BioShield, which when investigated turned out to be a 128 megabyte USB flash drive with no additional electronics or software. They were charging $350 for a device that did nothing. Others are hoping that riding on the back of a wave of anti-5G sentiment will help their political careers. And it's hard to know whether they actually believe the claims or not. You may be wondering why you should trust me. And that's the right attitude to have. You shouldn't necessarily trust what somebody says about 5G just because they were able to make a video on the internet. But if you are interested in learning more, have a look at the links in the description.